Alright, and we're live.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Miguel Alejandro here reporting from Westwood at the Veterans Community Center in a beautiful sunny day. And I am here joined today by Matt. How are you doing, Matt?
Doing pretty good. We got a nice, beautiful day out here. Blue sky, no clouds whatsoever. Right smack in the middle of Westwood near Santa Monica by the Getty Center. I have to say, it's absolutely beautiful out here.
Yeah, couldn't ask for a nicer day. There's a light breeze out. Not too windy though, so we won't have too much interference, and we're about ready to hit it off between the Anteater Quidditch of UCI and the Westwood Wizards.
Alright, we just got a brooms up. Looks like the Wizards have gotten in control of the Quaffle, but UCI has gotten in control of the Bludgers.
Wizards keeper now making her way up with the Quaffle, and it's going to be an interesting game.
Being charged by Anteater Quidditch, passes it off to number 23 of the Wizards. 23 again, being pressured by Ellis on Quidditch, passes it off to another Wizard. Wizard being charged by, can't quite tell who that is. Wizards pass it off yet again towards their own hoops. Ball is just bouncing at this point and is picked up by another Wizard.
See, so we have now a 2-1 record here for Anteater Quidditch on this tournament day. Losing to UCLA, but beating Lost Boys, who are actually ranked number 20
in the nation.
Yeah, in the nation, so overall division. And we have a pass to number 15 of the Wizards, which is completed. The shot to number 7, again completed. Number 35 with the Quaffle, but Claire of Anteater Quidditch is going to tag him out with a beat. Now they're making their way up the pitch.
You got this!
All right, AQ with the ball. Keeper, Miguel, taking the ball upfield nice and slow. AQ setting up their offense.
And we have an attempt at a beat, but no good. Wizards hold on to the ball, and...
and there has been a delay of play.
Whistle is blown. Ref calls that the ball goes to AQ, number 99 with the ball, holding on to it. Rojo, number 24, anxiously waiting in the background.
All right, and play is resumed. Miguel taking advantage of this stop and game to charge up ahead.
Woo!
And he takes a shot, and he makes it.
Score now is 1-0 in favor of the Anteaters.
All right, and it looks like the Wizards have tossed the ball back up, and they're getting ready to make their advance.
Ready for a reset here now with two referees on either side of the pitch. Number 15 of the Wizards hacking his way slowly up the field, marching it up with the Quaffle.
Being charged by AQ, passes it back to his teammate, who just barely manages to grab it, but they have managed to successfully reset the ball. Looks like AQ is putting on some pressure, trying to put them up near their hoops. But number 24, Sydney Rogue, is that it? Rogo, sorry. Sydney Rogo, pressuring the ball.
It's going to be interesting to see the strategy here, because Anteater Quidditch has to conserve their energy throughout the game.
And it looks like he's driving the ball. He takes a shot, and it looks like it's a miss. But he manages to pass it off to number 35, who makes the shot.
Score is now 1-1. And the refs are summoning for a reset of the ball. Room still up.
We got Miguel over here as the goalkeeper of Anteater Quidditch, bringing the ball up nice and slow. The game is now tied 10-10, 1-1. And we'll see where it goes from here. Anteater Quidditch coming up with a slow offense, Miguel being met by someone on the other team. Looks like one of their beaters just got beat. Oh, and Miguel has unfortunately taken the beats.
I'm going to go ahead and predict a very slow-moving game, seeing as Anteater Quidditch has been playing. This is their fourth game of the day, so I wouldn't be surprised if they don't get above 50 points for the entire game, whoever wins.
Honestly, I would say they've been playing incredibly well from what I've seen so far, and I'd say they still have quite a bit of fight left in them, because hey, we're AQ, we're the underdogs. And it looks like we've actually managed to get the ball again, which is definitely a good thing. We got Miguel bringing the ball up slowly as well, being protected by Claire, our beater.
Number 99 of Anteater Quidditch also being very cautious with the ball.
That's a beater, actually. He's protecting the Quaffle. Looks like he passed it up to Sydney, who passes the ball to Princeton, who's going to be taking it.
Anteater Quidditch defense is being very cautious today. They are holding three people back in their downfield, making sure that Wizards cannot put any pressure on to the defense, but the offense is kind of having a hard time making a score. We have a stoppage of play here. Refs are calling on their consulting sideline assistants, seeing what happens.
Looks to be a conflict, and maybe one of the players that was beat. Maybe they're readjusting the hoops, so possibly someone ran into them.
All right. Calling for a remount, whistle blows, and brooms are back up.
All right, the Wizards definitely have the ball, are taking it upfield now. Looks like their offense is starting to run in, try to get past the defense that the Anteaters are putting up. Wizards passing it back to number 23. Carl Beater, number 39, on UCI, beats one of their team, but then gets beat himself. Wizards pass the ball up, getting some pressure from AQ.
Wind is picking up a little bit here, and as the field is mostly dirt, it's going to be interesting to see because it's going to be very sensitive for the eyes. Number 7 of Wizards taken down by our goalkeeper Miguel of Anteater Quidditch, and she'll have to go all the way back to her post.
Good job, AQ!
It looks like AQ has the ball again. Score is still 10-10, 1-1. AQ making yet another slow advance up the field, sort of collecting themselves, getting ready to make a play. Looks like number 24 is Sydney Rogo again, is going to be our person in the back behind the hoops. And we have Jacob Ellis on the left. And it looks like Miguel's looking for an opportunity here, being pressured by the Wizards, looking for someone to pass to.
Number 15 tagged out by our
beater Claire. Beater Claire has taken out the pressure on the quaffle. And it looks like he has yet another person to deal with here as he's looking for the pass. Miguel driving it in. He's taking it in. They got no beaters. He gets beat. He tosses the ball.
Toss over. It to number 24.
Number 24 is Sydney taking the ball. Holding onto it in the back. And it looks like the refs making her drop it because it went out of play.
They have such a wide field to play on, but yet, if it goes out of bounds, they're gonna have to call in for a reset.
Yeah, that is correct. All right, so it looks like the Wizards of Westwood are starting with the ball, although AQ definitely does have bludger control at the moment. Looks like the bludger on one of the bludgers on Wizards just went up with the ball. As a distraction, Wizards going up with the ball towards the hoops. He passes it towards the center.
Unsuccessful shot. Number 7 of Westwood now tossing it to number 23, who catches the quaffle, picks it up, and is looking for an open man or a woman.
Good job, AQ!
All right, and it looks like the goalkeeper on the Wizards side has decided to take the ball up. He passes it off to someone else on his team, and they got a beater up there protecting them. Wizards guy decides to drive up towards the field. Looks like, though, he got beat.
It looked like a score from here, but apparently the ref didn't call anything.
It wasn't anything.
Ellis and number 7 of Westwood now fighting it out on the ground, having a scuffle, but referee calls it off. Miguel, once again, our keeper with the quaffle, making his way slowly up. Only one bludger for AQ side, and two on the side of Wizards.
I would say definitely AQ's defense has been very, very good, doing very, very well up to this point, considering that the game is still tied 1-1. But also on that same token, the Wizards' defense has been shutting them down somewhat frequently. I would say both teams are definitely putting on some great moves at this point.
Claire and another beater from the Wizards have simultaneously taken themselves out.
Miguel deflecting the bludger, driving it towards the hoops, getting into a bit of a scuffle, passes it off to
Rogo,
Sydney.
Not able to catch it.
Not able to catch it, but Jacob Ellis catches it and is beat. And the ball is taken by the Wizards, who drive it up, and it looks like this might be their next score.
Ellis looking to make the return to field, but he was unsuccessful. He was beat, and they said that the throw of the Wizards was good, making it 20-10.
2-1.
Seems that we have a flag here. Did you see anything?
A flag? No, I don't believe so.
Now the ref pulled something out through the whistle, so we'll have to see what happens. Number 23 of Wizards being switched out, leaving the pitch.
Alright, ref has called for a remount, getting prepared to blow his whistle. As soon as the whistle is blown, it will be AQ's ball. And it looks like AQ, actually no, sorry about that. It looks like the Wizards at the moment have bludger control. Alright, the whistle has been blown, back into play. Number 24 has been swapped out, and it looks like AQ is starting their first round of substitutes. Right. Adjusted AQ lineup is now, let's see, number 420, Luke Rouse. Number 917, Emily. Number P, Mr. Ellis. And keeper is Colin Casey, who currently has the ball.
Keeper looking for a shot, and he throws it.
He throws it off into the back.
Taken by Rogo, but it's good.
Actually, that would be Emily. We have a shot made by Emily, number 917 on AQ, tying the game up to 20-20. All right, and we got Wizards. They got the ball. Going to be taking it upfield. And it looks like AQ is in bludger control. All right.
Wizards with the quaffle, trying to find an out.
Wizards being put under quite a bit of pressure here, passes the ball off to the side and decides to reset it into the back.
Number 7 tossing it back to their teammate of the Wizards for a quick turnaround. But number 816
Hodges.
Hodge
is putting quite a bit of pressure, driving the Wizards back behind their own hoops. Looks like the Wizards, though, managed to juke him out, and the AQ defense has decided to reset itself. Wizards dribbling up the left side of the field. Still running with the ball.
Very well. Manages to throw it. Going in for the score. Makes it. So now we have the reset. Two of the Wizards that were beat in the play, number 25 and number...
We got Cullen, number 101 on the AQ, making a rush up. Takes a shot, doesn't make it, but manages to get it back to his own team member, who passes it off. And they make it, and it's now 30-30. Or 3-3, I guess. All right. We got the goalkeeper on the side of the Wizards, taking the ball up the field. Looks like the refs are complaining about something else.
They're always complaining about something.
AQ putting quite a bit of pressure on the other team's goalkeeper.
I think I'm seeing a pattern here with maybe perhaps both teams. It seems that they're alternating between rounds of keeping their goalkeeper hanging back, and then in another round they'll take the whole team up the field. So I think they're maybe testing out the waters and seeing how the Anteater Quidditch defense responds to this kind of pressure.
Yeah, I agree. And it looks like the goalkeeper as well is making a run up the field. Or I'm sorry, that is a chaser right there. Looks like they've just tried to make the shot but missed.
Number 420 putting pressure onto the quaffle holder of the Wizards.
Looks like one of the Wizards is tying his shoes. Not entirely sure what's going on over there. But AQ definitely does have the... Actually, no, that's one of our... That would be one of the Anteater Quidditch folk tying their shoes. And it looks like AQ has the ball.
Wind is starting to pick up a little more now, so we're going to have to be careful with those long passes for the quaffle. And we're going to have to make sure that those bludger hits are from up close.
Goalkeeper Austin Sharp dodging the bludger, getting caught up, passes the ball off.
Number 12 of AQ, kicking the bludger to 420, but the refs call, they call for a remount now.
AQ, you got this!
Call for a remount. The shot that went in was not counted because I guess the person was beaten before. And it looks like the refs have decided to give the ball back to the Wizards. AQ is going to have to reset as soon as possible to try and avoid any kind of fast break from the Wizards. Although it looks like they're not going for one, so AQ is good.
Whistle is blown, and they're going to have to sub out number 15 of the Wizards. One of the AQ dropped their broom, so he's going to have to go back for the reset. Number 17 of Wizards putting some pressure onto the AQ defense, and number 15 with toss to the defense, but it's unsuccessful. And
good job, AQ!
420 of AQ now in possession of a bludger, and seems to be number 6 of AQ in possession of the qual.
All right. Yes, number 6, that would be Austin Sharp, AQ's one of AQ's goalkeepers, with the ball. Looks like number 420 has beaten the chaser that would be pressuring our goalkeeper, but another one has decided to pressure him already, and it looks like he's been beaten. Although it looks like over on the edge, we got player Tree of AQ taking the ball upfield, trying to go for the goal.
Looking for someone to pass it to, but he's just going to have to pass it all the way back.
Where the ball would be picked up.
Sharp gets the quaffle.
By the goalkeeper.
He's being covered by Rads for 20 of AQ. Ref making sure that nothing's getting too serious, but they might be interfering with the ball in play.
Beater thrown at goalkeeper Sharp, who dodges it, though he manages to get tackled. Throws the ball out. There's a call by the ref. See what that's all about in just a second.
Ooh,
and the ref has awarded a yellow card.
That'll be a yellow card for 420. I believe that was foul play. Didn't see exactly what happened.
And it looks like, I believe it was incorrect usage of the fist up during a beater play. But I'm not entirely sure. We'll have to check the footage afterward.
Regardless, he is out for the time being, and so his indefinite departure from the team definitely puts them a man under, and so now...
Well, no, they just swapped someone else in.
Gotcha.
All right. Wizards taking it up, gets tackled, gets knocked to the floor by Captain Joseph, by our Captain Joe, and it looks like AQ has the ball yet again. I don't know about you, but I heard that tackle from here.
Yeah, that was a very brutal throw down to the ground. I could just imagine, you know, on this, like, ungrassed field, how that would feel.
Goalkeeper Austin Beat throws the ball up, who then takes it up, and that is a goal. That is a shot for AQ. Although the Wizards are dribbling it up, and they answer, I believe, with their own goal.
Score is now evened once again.
Actually, 40-40. Even 40-40. Wow, that's insane. And it looks like AQ is subbing in some new beaters.
Claire and number 18 of
John.
Number 13 of AQ coming back in. Number 6, Sharp looking for the toss, and number 15.
But he gets beaten, unfortunately. And number 15 of the Wizards does recover it. 15 of the Wizards making a run up the field. Sprinting up, he throws it off to his teammate over on the edge.
Number 11 tries to get the quaffle, but is beat and has to run back.
And it turns out the ball has been reset by AQ's goalkeeper.
Now that they have one yellow flag under their belt, if I were AQ, I would be a little afraid of that ref. He seems kind of trigger happy to call plays.
Ball gets passed back to team captain, number 29. Was looking for the pass. He's being pressured by the Wizards. He decides to run around. He dodges the beat, takes a shot, and makes it.
Woo! AQ!
All right. AQ up now, 50-40, 5-4. And it looks like the Wizards will be swapping some of their people out as well. And they'll be coming up the field with their own. play.
We're now reaching about 20 minutes of...